You know, I think one of the opportunities here, and I've said before, you know, we have to take this terrible storm that whacked Vermonters and kicked so many people in the teeth, we have to turn it into an opportunity. And the opportunity in this particular case of our mental health patients in Vermont is that the facility that got flooded was inadequate to deliver them care. The federal government had deemed it inadequate to deliver them care. It was costing Vermont taxpayers about $10 million a year because the federal government would no longer reimburse because of the quality of the facility. So our job now is to come up with a solution, and we've just outlined that solution. You haven't asked about the financial impact of this, but I think it's worth mentioning that we believe that all the options that we've just outlined in this plan will qualify for the Medicaid, Medicare match that was taken from Vermonters over the last many years. What that means is that not only do we think this will be a better delivery system than what we had, but we also believe that it will cost Vermont taxpayers less money because we will go back qualifying for the 60% federal match, 40% state dollars for almost all of the proposals that have just been outlined. Additionally, we believe that FEMA will help us with fit-up costs for some of the investments that we need to make to make this system work. That hasn't been confirmed, but we think it's highly likely that as we invest in fit-up costs at the Brattleboro Retreat, Central Vermont, or Pine Ridge, that some of those costs will be underwritten through a FEMA reimbursement. So this isn't just a better delivery plan, it's also a better deal for Vermont taxpayers, and we think we've outlined a plan that will work.